June is a Japanese film from director Shinya Tsukamoto, known for films like Tetsu, The Iron Man, and Nightmare Detective. People who are familiar with some of his other films will know just what to expect here, but for newcomers, they should be aware that his movies are a very unique breed. They rarely follow genre conventions, and they typically have a lot of underlying themes beyond the surface. A Snake of June will take audiences on a very strange and bizarre experience that really focuses a lot on sexuality. It's a unique style that won't appeal necessarily to a wide range of people, but for those who are looking for a really unique and different experience, or for those who are interested in cinema itself, I think they'll find a lot to like here. The story of the film revolves around a married couple who get along well enough, but seem to be lacking a great deal of intimacy in their relationship. In the beginning, these characters seem to be okay with the way they live out their lives and their relationship in general. However, audiences will quickly discover that there are some strong desires and needs that these characters crave that are not necessarily being met in their relationship. This becomes realized when a character is introduced into the story that blackmails the main actress into performing some of her fantasies that in actuality she wouldn't dream of doing openly. A very important thing to point out is that although the film focuses heavily on a lot of sexual themes, it never gets to the point where it seems like exploitation. While the movie does certainly show some nudity from time to time, what I found very interesting was that it seemed to be interested in showing the characters' emotions more than anything else. There are quite a few scenes, front and center, you know, where the characters' faces are the focal point. You will almost always see a reaction on screen, and this almost becomes more important than the words that are actually being spoken. And therefore, the movie never ends up feeling cheap or dirty. Instead, it does a really good job at making you feel like you're a true witness, as you seem to get very close with the people that are on screen. What I really admired about this film was how much it made me feel like I was watching one long dream sequence. I remember watching this director's film, Nightmare Detective, and truly loving how it embodied its title, like I felt like I was in an actual nightmare. And this movie has a very similar sort of quality. It's about the blackmailer making this character act out her fantasies, and only these fantasies do not involve locations or creatures that don't exist like most dreams, but rather everything on display here is believable. Like, these characters are in a real city with real people, but are doing things that are really out of their comfort zone. Personally, I found that when I have nightmares myself, the most memorable moments are those that involve realistic aspects. You know, whether it be locations I often visit in my everyday life, or involve people that I know very well. I think that relates very well to this movie, since this fantasy or nightmare does not make for the best horror film out there, but it certainly makes for a really memorable movie overall. The movie's unique visual style also does a great job of making it truly stand out. The entire film is displayed in this sort of blue-colored monochrome, and it makes for some really nice-looking moments every now and then, and I didn't feel like it distracted me or took anything away from the film in any way. I'm pretty sure that some people may be off-put by it, or perhaps others may think it's some sort of cheap trick to try to get attention, but for me it was a great decision, as it goes a long way towards helping the film pull off its dreamlike quality that I really enjoyed. I also thought it did a great job at complementing the fact that there is a ton of water on display here, since it's practically raining during every scene in the film. The Region 1 DVD release of A Snake of June comes from Tartan Asia Extreme. The special features on the disc included a photo gallery, trailers for other Tartan Asia Extreme releases, and two behind-the-scenes featurettes. One of those featurettes focused on showing interviews with the cast of the film, and the other one focused on the technical side of things, like the shooting of the film and the post-production. Hearing the director talk about how excited he was to play the stalker character in the film was really interesting. At one point, he essentially said that he wouldn't have made the film unless he got to play the role. So I found that to be neat, and also hearing about the topics like the sound, music, lighting, and the choices regarding the style of the film were also all well worth watching. While there are a number of well-done scenes in the movie that may make viewers feel uncomfortable, this is not meant to be a horror movie, so people who are interested in watching a scary movie should really look elsewhere. I'm pretty sure that going into experience, you know, this unique without being prepared is likely to lead to disappointment in a lot of cases. I personally could not watch movies like this every day. Sometimes I just like to sit back, you know, turn off my brain, and let a movie provide me with mindless entertainment. This movie does a really good job, though, at reminding me that there are many unique and intelligent films out there. With so many movies sticking to standard genre conventions, it's nice to see movies like this one that are interested in providing an overall experience rather than fitting into a category like horror, thriller, or science fiction. It's not my favorite movie from this director, but it's one that I really do respect and appreciate. So if you're interested, I think it's well worth a look.